Friends, the topic of today's podcast is value investing's pain. There have been times when value investing did not generate returns, while some other more aggressive styles did very well. If you take the US, the current phase seems to be one such phase. India has been no different if you look at how the Nifty has been doing in the last 12 to 18 months. On the other hand, value investing has virtually done little or nothing. It is in those phases that this existential question keeps cropping up. At a time when even in India, very large and significant assets are being driven by value investing, by the top fund managers in the country, this question becomes all the more relevant. When was the last time that this existential question came up? Interestingly, it came up in the late 90s, when tech stocks were the only things that mattered in the market. Typically, this kind of situation arises and the existential question gets thrown up only when one small category of stocks dominates the market. That's when people find it very easy to dismiss all other forms and get convinced that this is the only way to invest. So, that was one phase when value investing did not work for close to 2 years between 1998 and 2000. Just like we are having to 2017 to 2019 right now. But I had a very interesting observation that came up when this question was discussed by me in private with somebody more senior than me. He said, look at it this way, all those large fund managers of that era who chased the other style of investing, which is more momentum oriented, are not in fund management jobs in the mutual fund industry anymore. They had to leave those vocations and become proprietary or assume some other roles. The only guys who have survived those 20 years to this day, and he mentioned two names, are those who stuck to their investment belief in value investing. The others got cleaned out between 2001 and 2004. Many of them today prophesize to us extensively because public memory is very short. The same phenomenon repeated in 2008 as well, with the difference that those who believed in value were actually buying what later on became growth businesses. So that's something which we didn't notice that much. But 1998-99 was a very stark phase and comparable to 2017 and 19, this phase. So, from a sustenance point of view and from a sensibility point of view, value investing has definitely survived, even if it has not thrived all along. And in the investment world, survival itself is a symptom of thriving. We tend to forget that. So, we think that doing well all the time is a symptom of thriving, but that never happens because when the tide turns, those who are doing very well get carried away and get drowned in the tide itself. And that's what happened in the beginning of this century to many of those who in 98, 99 and 2000 almost became prophets. They almost became prophets. And they ended up in a very bad place. Leaving history there, let's come to the present. This pain is quite reminiscent of that pain because people have stuck to conservatism, stuck to valuations, bought businesses at very reasonable valuations and been punished. this has created a feeling in our minds that they probably won't get rewarded at all. That's the kind of terminal judgments that have been formed in these 2 years. Clearly, we are not having the right investment horizon. So, there is a good chance that many people who have completed their judgments will make investment actions based on these judgments right now. And over the next 2 years, these very guys who didn't do well for these 2-3 years may be the marquee performers, while those who prophesized that they knew this magic potion of consistent returns may be in a very difficult place. If you look at history, one Spain later gets transferred to the other guy, and vice versa. So this Spain is not something that should be dismissed, or it's not something that you need to think lowly of. It's just a position in which one school of investing finds itself in the cycle of time. Market cycles change, this pain can get released very fast, and it could turn into returns. But one thing which consistently happened with these marquee guys is that they stuck to what they did even when the pain was maximum. So as an investor who is invested in their funds or in their philosophy, the choice before you is simple. Just sticking and riding out the tide will probably take you to a higher place because the tide has to rise. Jumping out of the ship now probably will still down you when the tide rises because you don't know how to swim at that point in time. So at least sticking to your boats where you are now traveling is probably sensible. And that's what is the big lesson of 98, 99, 2000. Many of the stocks which looked as wrong decisions in that phase became your 100 baggers. I can give SRF as a classic example. There are TTK Prestige. There are many, many more such companies, and several of these companies today which we think are widow stocks, not worth owning, could well turn out to be the market favorites with time. The question is, do you have the patience to endure that pain? But one thing which all of us should remember, that stock market is a place where those who bore the pain always made the bigger gains, while those who thought that they could travel painlessly found that their journey slowed down after a while. The value investing's pain, which we see today, is probably something that will go away. I don't know when, but when it goes away, it's going to be resulting in a lot of gain. Happy invested. Stay tuned. Subscribe to our channel and hear our views and engage with us. Thank you very much.